Sasha. My question is, why does society affect our decisions and why do we let it affect our decisions?
Have I not already answered it? Pay attention to this. See, the society is again like the gusts of wind that come from everywhere. If you are connected to yourself, then the society will prove to be a help to you. Think of two people, both sitting on Google, both sitting on internet. एक को पता है उसे क्या खोजना है. The Google will be of immense help to him. He knows himself. The other one has no idea what it is like. वो वहां जाएगा तो क्या करेगा? Some random thing. बाहर जो भी है वो useful भी हो सकता है और harmful भी हो सकता है. Depend करता है कि आपको पता है या कि आपको क्या चाहिए. The world is like a supermarket. Everything is available. Do you know what to purchase? Everything is available. There is so much of happiness. There is an equal amount of misery. There is attention, there is attention. There are people who can make your life beautiful and there are people who can provide you with so much of misery. तुम ये देखो कि तुम्हारे चुनाव कैसे हुए हैं. लोगों ने कुछ नहीं किया है, सब कुछ उपलब्ध है. There is night and there is day. You see what you want to choose. There is a highway. And there is a subway. You see what you want to choose. The world is available. Entire existence is available to you and you are very young. Do you know what you want? Are you in touch with yourself? And how can you be in touch with yourself when all the time you are looking only outwards? When all the time your attention is only on things that are outside? How can you be in touch with yourself? Even sitting here, look at the time you are spending in watching at your friend. You're just gaping at him. What's so seductive about the face of the person sitting next to you that you can't resist looking at him or her? What is it? What is it that is so seductive about his face? Your attention. These 40 minutes were a beautiful opportunity for your attention to go inwards. Instead, it is still roaming around. अब आप किसी दूसरे को दोष क्यों दो अगर आप ऑब्लिगेशन से बंधे हो, अगर आप पाते हो कि आपकी जिंदगी में फ्रीडम नहीं है, अगर आप बार बार फ्रस्ट्रेट होते रहते हो, फिर आप छोटे मोटे रिवेलियंस करते हो. बड़ा रिवेलियन तो कर पाने की क्षमता नहीं है, तो फिर आप छोटे रिवेलियंस करते हो. कैसे करते हो? सेशन 10-15 से वो भी थोड़ा सा बड़ा हो जाता है और उससे भी छोटा. 10-15 का सेशन है, हम 10-25 पे आएंगे. हमने क्या किया? हमने रिवेलियन किया. रिवेलियन जानना चाहते हो? जाके देखो भगत सिंह को. दैट इज अ रिवेलियन. एट योर एज ही हैड ऑलरेडी डन व्हाट ही नीडेड टू डू एंड एट द एज ऑफ 22 ही हैड बीन हैंग्ड. मेनी ऑफ यू वुड बी अप्रोचिंग दैट एज इन अनदर 3-4 इयर्स. मोस्ट ऑफ यू आर. ये होता है रिवेलियन. और तो रिवेलियन भी कैसे होते हैं कि हमसे बोला गया आगे आके बैठो, हम पीछे ही बैठे रहेंगे. ये क्या है? तुम्हारा माइक्रो रिवेलियन है. Observe what can you attend to if you are all the time vibrating. Be still, and then everything will become obvious, very, very obvious. It is not your age to feel bored. This is the age in which your faces must glow with attention, with life. This is not the age to feel frustrated. This is not the age when you should slouch on chairs. Look at the body language of most of you. Are you young? Really young? Physically you may be. Hormones don't make a man young. Physically you might be. But you are already very, very old from here. Aren't you? is the difference between a living tree and this furniture? A young tree and this furniture. What is the difference? What is the difference between a young tree and this timber that you see all around? Yeah? The tree is responsive. The tree can change. The tree will shed its leaves and the tree will sprout new ones. The tree will flower. This timber is never going to flower again. It looks beautiful. Sitting here, it looks beautiful, very polished, very nice, very decent, glowy and jazzy. But it is dead. To be young is to be like the tree, open to existence, receiving air, receiving water. Are you receptive? Are you receiving? I'm not talking about being influenced. Influenced is you. I'm not talking about being influenced, I'm talking about being receptive. And do you know what being receptive means? Isko agar hum maarta ho, to isme bas yahi hoga ki every action is an equal and opposite reaction. Correct? It dead hai. Iske saath bas Newton's laws operate karenge. Tree ke saath nahi operate karte. Tree leta hai sunlight aur usko kuch aur hi bana deta hai apni understanding se. Tree leta hai fertilizer aur pani aur sunlight aur usme se phool bana deta hai. No science can ever explain how a flower blossoms out of sunlight and soil. Can any science ever explain it? That is being young, being receptive, taking everything from everywhere. And you cannot take things from everywhere if you are vibrating. Imagine a tree that is vibrating. Be still, be attentive, and then you will find that you are able to receive. That is good, really good. That from there comes great energy, great vitality. Really useful.